Hello everyone, I am Kamal here. I hope you all are fine and keep in touch with your syllabus because this is the right time to work hard at home. So let's start our video. This is our fourth video. Today we will discuss about the chapter further. Today we will discuss about first ions and their names and symbols, then ionic bond, then covalent bond, polyatomic ions, steps for ionic compounds. So let's start with ions first. What do you mean by ions? Ions are the charged particles formed by the loss or gain of electrons by an atom or group of atoms. Ions are formed when an atom loses electrons or gain electrons. Then that will form is called ions. For example, a sodium atom loses one electron and a chlorine atom accepts one electron to form sodium chloride. Here, this is the example. This is the symbol of sodium. It loses one electron and form Na positive. This is an ion. And here, chlorine is an atom. It gains one electron and form Cl negative. This is chloride ion. Okay, then these two ions combine together and form NaCl, sodium chloride. Here positive sign represents positive ion and negative sign represents the negative ion. Positive is formed when the atom loses one electron, and negative ion is formed when the atom gains one electron. So next is names and symbols of ions. An atom or a group of atoms that loses electron, that will form a positive ion, and that positive ion is called the cation. The atom that loses electron, that will form cation. An atom or a group of atoms that gains electrons form a negative ion, and that negative ion is called the anion. Next one is how we write the name of these ions. To name positive ions or cations, write the name from the periodic table and add the word ion afterward. After writing the name, then we have to write the ion name in case of positive ions. For example, if there is a sodium ion, this is a positive ion, so we have to write down ion after the name of sodium. We have write down ion. In case of negative ions or anions, write the name from the periodic table and replace the ending with ion. We have to replace the ending with ion. Put the word ion after the name. This is the chloride ion. This is a negative ion. And in case of negative ion, we have to choose first their name. This is chlorine. We have to replace the ending with ion. We have to replace the ending of chlorine with ion. We have write chloride. And then we have to write down the ion. This is called the chloride ion. So in case of positive, we have only write the ion in after the name of the compound. And in case of negative ions, we have to write down first ion, then ion. In the symbol of an ion, the magnitude and sign of the charge are written as superscript on the right side of the chemical symbol of the element. Means if you have given ion greater than 1, that is it is 2 positive charge. If the charge is given to you is more than 1, 2, 3 also, okay, then you have to write it on the right hand side and on the upper side of the compound name. Next is if we have only one, like one positive, one negative, then we have to neglect that one. Okay, this is the This is the chart given for you. There are the elements and the name of the ions and the symbols of the ion. Here the element is iron, and the ions and the name of this element is ferrous, ferric, and the symbol for ferrous is Fe2 positive, and the symbol for ferric ion is Fe3 positive. This is the element sodium, and the name of the ion is sodium ion, and the symbol of the ion is Na positive. For potassium, the ion name is potassium ion, and the symbol is K positive. In case of calcium, it is calcium ion, and the symbol is Ca2 positive. Okay, here the charge present is 2 positive. In case of negative ions like fluorine, this is F negative. We have read now that in case of negative ions, we have to write iodide first, then the ion. So in case of fluorine, we have write fluoride ion and F negative. For chlorine, the ion name is chloride ion, and the symbol that is used for chloride ion is Cl negative. So you must learn these symbols and their names. Next is the ionic bond. What do you mean by ionic bond? What is the bond? Bond is that which links the two atoms. Okay, like in case of ionic bond, when the atom loses one electron or more, then it will form positive ion. You know that when the atom loses one electron, then it will form positive ion or cation. When the atom gains one electron or more, then it will form negative ion, that is called anion. So when the bond is formed between the positive and the negative, because positive is ion and negative is also ion, when the bond is formed between the ions, that bond is called the ionic bond. That bonding is called the ionic bonding or electrovalent. So in ionic bond, the transfer of one electron from the metal to the non-metal. In ionic bonding, what will happen? One atom loses its electron and the other atom gain that electrons and form a bond. That is called the ionic bond. Here, mostly the metals lose their electrons and form cations, and the non-metals mostly accepts the electron and form anions. For example, in case of sodium chloride, it is the combination of sodium and chloride ion. So sodium ion is formed by the when the sodium atom loses one electron and chlorine atom gains one electron from the sodium and form chloride ion, that is also called chloride anion. Next is the oppositely charged ions attract each other. In first case, sodium will convert into Na positive plus electron, means it will give one electron to the chlorine. So here one is the positively charged and the other one is the negatively charged. You know that the positive and the negative charges attract each other, that the two oppositely charged ions attract each other, so they combine together and form NaCl compound. This is a positively charged ion and this is a negatively charged ion. Both are of opposite charges, and the opposite charges attract each other. Okay, then it will combine to form NaCl. Next is the covalent bond. What do you mean by covalent bond? In ionic bond, one atom loses electron and the other atom gain that electrons. But in case of covalent bond, what will happen? Sharing takes place. The electrons are shared between the elements. That is called, then the bond is formed is called the covalent bond. In this, there is a sharing of electrons takes place. For example, in case of water, here hydrogen having one electron, oxygen having two electrons, and hydrogen having one electron. And hydrogen and oxygen shares these electrons, and this oxygen and this hydrogen share these electrons, like in this way. So they will form water molecule. Here you know that hydrogen having only one valency, so it will combine with one. So here hydrogen combine with one, and oxygen having valency two, then it will combine with two atoms. The two atoms are these two atoms, H. These hydrogen are the two atoms, and the oxygen's valency is two, so the oxygen combined with these two atoms. Next one is polyatomic ions. Poly means many. The ions in which there are many atoms are present. Okay? Sometimes a group of atoms functions as a single unit. When the group of atoms function as a single unit, they carry positive or negative charge and are called the polyatomic ion. When the group of atoms function like a single unit, they serve as a single unit. They contain positive charge also and the negative charge also. So these are called the polyatomic ion, in which the many atoms are present. These are highly reactive and also called the radicals. Polyatomic ions also called radicals. For example, this is a carbonate ion. This is a carbonate ion. Here one carbon and three oxygen atoms are present. This is ion because here two negative charges are present. So this is the example of polyatomic ion. Here this is a table given for you. These are the polyatomic ions. These are their chemical formulas and valency and charge. Valency and charge is same. If they, for example, in case of sulfate, it having two negative charge, so its valency is two. If carbonate having two negative charge, then its valency is two. Okay, so valency and charge is same. So here we have to discuss the steps for the compounds containing ions. You know the how to write the names of the compound. We have already done the steps for the compounds. Now the compounds are those that containing the ions. So here the first step is write the formula of the cation first and the anion first. If the compound contain both cations and anions, then we have to write down the formula of the cation first and then that of the anion. Next step is write the valencies of the compound. Third step is cross over the valencies. Fourth is if the compound formed by the combination of monoatomic and polyatomic ions, the polyatomic ions are enclosed in the brackets. If the compound is formed with the combination of monoatomic and polyatomic, then the polyatomic ions are written in the brackets if their valency is 2 or more than 2. This is the condition when the polyatomic ions written in the bracket if the valency is 2 or more than 2. If the valencies can be simplified, then divide both the valencies with the common factor. Then we have to divide them with the common factor. If they are not divisible, then we have to write as it is. Like in case of, this is the example of monoatomic ions, magnesium oxide. Okay, first step is write down the symbol. Magnesium, for magnesium we have to use Mg, and for oxide we have to use O. Okay, means oxygen. Then second step is valency. Write the valency of magnesium. Magnesium having valency or charge plus 2. Okay, 2 positive charge and oxygen having 2 negative charge. Then the third step is crossover. We have to cross over them. Mg 2 negative and O 2. We have taken here magnitude. We have to take their values positive. Here this is Mg 2 and O 2. Their common factor is 2. So we have to divide 2 here and 2 here. So it will give 1 1. Mg 1 and O 1. Okay? So step 5 is write down the formula, that is MgO. Next is the example of polyatomic ions, that is a sodium carbonate. Polyatomic ion is sodium carbonate. Here this is the monatomic and this is the polyatomic. So we have to write down the polyatomic in the brackets. Firstly we have write down the cation first, then the anion. Okay, like the our first step is write down the cation first and then the anion. So in this, the first step is write down the symbol of sodium. Sodium symbol is Na and carbonate symbol is CO3. Okay, then step 2 is valency. Sodium having valency plus 1 and carbonate having valency 2 minus 2. Okay, so then we have to cross over them. Next step is the third step is cross over. Here we have cross over them Na2 and CO3 1. Okay, Na contain 2 and carbonate contain 1. So we have simplified them by dividing the common factor. Here common factor is 1. So we have if we have to divide with 1, then it will remain 2. 1 with 1, it will remain with 1. So Na2 and CO3. This is the formula. So keep the steps in your mind that we have first write the name of the cation, then the name of the anion. If we have polyatomic ions, then we have first write the monoatomic, then the polyatomic in the brackets. So I hope you like this video. Thanks.